like we're standing on the holy ground here today. He told Moses to take off his shoes from his feet. We're standing on holy ground. Hallelujah. I wonder if there's somebody here today that would take your shoes off and just stand on holy ground. You might be thinking, is he being naturally and spiritually? I can do whatever you feel. I just wonder today. I feel such a holy presence of God in this place. Can we take off our shoes? Can we lay ourselves down before the Lord today? Say, Lord, here I am to worship you. Right here as I'm standing on the holy ground. Where it's not about me, but it's about you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. Come on, somebody standing on holy ground. I believe this altar right now is holy ground. going to sing. Just go ahead and leave if you leave the platform if you want to. We just worship God. Oh, we love you, Jesus. Come on, you're standing on some holy ground in this place. You're standing on anointed ground in this place, where the presence of God is resting, waiting to touch your life, waiting to bless you.
Our heart is consumed with Jesus. Thank you. Thank you.
afraid to speak out. If you feel like God's giving you a word, don't be afraid to speak out.
God help me as we step from this point into greater vision. This is all happening. prophecy is a little bit more different than what people think it is. I know. Thank the Lord.
Oh. Amen. God spoke to me earlier today, this morning, just said that we were going to experience just a taste of the depth of what God has for us. I believe that in this place we've experienced just a taste, a true taste of the depth of what God has for us. If you're a first-time guest, if you've only been here a couple of times, the Bible talks about the gifts of the Spirit, that there are going to be tongues and an interpretation of tongues. When the Spirit of the Lord begins to move in and ministers through a single voice and addresses the body of believers as a whole, not the same thing as the gift of the Spirit or the gift of tongues when we receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. It's a separate thing. God begins to choose to speak to an entire body. There's a holy presence that begins to flow in. I mean, God has given us a taste of the deep things, things that we have been longing for as a church, things that we have talked about, things that we have read about, things that we have prayed about. God is getting us to that point. But don't be afraid to be used in the gifts of the Spirit. Don't be afraid to step out and be used in tongues or interpretation of tongues or be used in whatever capacity that God has for you. Because the more we get into this, the more we're going to see greater miracles, greater signs, more people receiving the Holy Ghost, more people being baptized in the precious name of Jesus. Truly, I believe we are standing on holy ground. The presence of God is resting upon each and every one of us. Has been resting in this building. People have come in, have been healed, have been delivered, have been set free. Every time we gather together, we need to make sure that we have prepared ourselves, that we've done all that we can to make sure that the presence of God is dwelling here. We're going to see even deeper things of God. Would you lift your hands here today? Would you just lift your hands with us? Hallelujah. You let the depth of God just begin to flow over you. Can you allow just the depth of the presence of God? Because sometimes you get to a point in His presence where you can't even speak. You just sit there in awe. You just sit there and say, God, I don't even have the words to say. Just help me. Help me be a better person. Help me be a stronger person. Sometimes you just get to the point where nothing else truly matters. You're just in the depth of God and you pray so intensely and you pray so fervently. You truly are touching God right in His very heartbeat. God longs for a relationship like this. He longs for a relationship that will push to the deep things, that will push to see more and experience more. Hallelujah. We don't get here by accident. It's taken work. It's taken months of prayers, months of fasting. It's taken consecration. But when you put all these things together, we get into this place of the Spirit where it's so powerful and so anointed. You got goosebumps on top of goosebumps. There's such a thick cloud in His presence here. This is just a taste, but don't stop at a taste. Taste this and want more. Taste this and want to go further. Moses said, show me your glory.